not a tree. Space.
What? No.
No. I'm like, kind of want to see a tree.
No, that's Destiny. Destiny has trees. Halo only has spaceships and guns.
That real makes gamers. Me sad.
It should not. You should be ecstatic and delighted. I can't hear my game.
That's your problem. That sounds like a Pat problem. Yeah, that's my problem.
I agreed to be quiet at this point, but there's a lot I want to tell you.
I made the game too quiet, so if you talk, Pat, you're going to blow my ears out. After this cutscene, I got to adjust this shit.
Captain Keys.
This is very Battlestar.
It's extremely early 2000 sci-fi is what it is. Case in point.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I'm a green guy with a sexy, glowy woman inside of me waiting to come out.
Be critical of the media you love, and Halo definitely has, like, two non-objectified women across five games. It's
and Cortana's not one of them.
No, Cortana's not one of them.
I'll make the game louder, everyone. I know it's really quiet right now, but there's subtitles.
Move I have like fun facts about this guy, too. Sergeant Avery Johnson. You'll come to like him.
My God. Like, I was waiting for you to tell me, like, this dude's got a 3-novel arc.
He does.
Never give up the pistol. I fucking hate you, Pat.
That's not a lie. Contact Harvest is his book.
God damn it. Now I know what it feels like when my girlfriend listens to me talk about Destiny.
About Dean.
Yeah. Time to wake up the chief. See, I know this part. This is all I know. This is why I'm chatty. That and I can't hear shit.
Yeah, I think I've accidentally muted my game somehow, so I have to fix that.
Yeah, we'll pause. Double chief. No explanation, just two chiefs.
Oh, I have, don't worry, I have the explanation.
Oh, God.
Don't you, I know you were concerned.
I deeply. You're coming. I gotta adjust all sorts of audio levels. You're peaking just a little too much.
Okay.
All right. So step one, I want to hear Halo. We'll call it 70.
Oh, that's the problem.
I wasn't using my ears.
Hey, now I can, now I can hear the game that we're playing. Okay, that's great. Well, now I can tell you some of the stuff. So, in the early 2000s, just about every AAA game came released with a novel for some reason. Halo included. Halo came with The Fall of Reach. And so what you don't have here is the setup for basically why most of this is happening, which is fine, because the game just, like, in media race throws you into things. That's normal. But you will learn a lot about this later, but we are fleeing the planet of Reach, which has just been attacked and destroyed by the Covenant. We'll learn more about that later, so I'm not going to tell you too much about that in, you know, Halo Reach, that game.
Okay. Yeah, that's good. What else?
We jumped and ran away from them, but Covenant ships are faster than UNSC ships in their, like, light speed travel, so they actually got to where we were going before we did, even though we left first.
Okay.
So we came out of hyperspace, and they were, like, there waiting for us, and now we are under attack.
The Cylons! They're on top of us!
Sergeant Avery Johnson, he's a whole other thing that you'll learn about later. Technically, he's a Spartan 1. We're Spartan 2s.
Right.
I don't get it.
We're super soldiers.
And...
Master Chief.
We were taking a Betty by nap time because we did, like, a whole bunch of busy stuff in a book that doesn't super matter. But, like, we did have a gunfight on the hull of this ship inside of Slipspace, and that's pretty wild. But it never gets mentioned again, so don't worry about it. Let's go.
All right, cool.
My audio went away again.
Not my problem.
Yeah, you do that thing. I'm going to find out why my audio's gone again.
Oh, no. Spaceship! Don't blow up. Go through this. No. You know, for a guy who played this last night, you think I'd remember anything about where I'm supposed to go? It's pretty obvious, too. There you go. Open.
My menu has volume. It doesn't have volume.
Oh, gods. Oh, gods.
I guess I just don't get to hear anything for a while. Maybe a cutscene will fix it.
By the lords of Kobol!
Well, that's working. I can still...
I want a gun. And no, Salty, I'll never give up the pistol. I know you can have two guns and swap them around. I remember that much.
That's definitely one of the things about Halo CE is that Halo Combat Evolved is that unlike every other game, every gun in this fucking hits like a truck. And it includes just the best versions of every gun. The assault rifle has like 4,000 bullets and destroys anything in
right.
front of it.
Everything is an exotic.
The pistol is the best sniper that has ever existed in any Halo video game.
Really?
Yes. It like in multiplayer, if you had to choose between a pistol and a tank, you should pick the pistol every
pistol.
Time.
Wow. So this is how the game saves. It's checkpoint, right? So we gotta hit a checkpoint before we can stop.
Yeah, it's checkpoint system.
Cool.
I like that Cortana changed colors at some point in this game, too. So you did miss me.
Report! What I really like is that you can, like, do the old and new version in the game.
Yeah, I'm in the old graphics. Are you in the new graphics right now?
I'm in the new. I'm initiating Cold Protocol Article 2. We're
abandoning the Ark. That means you too, Cortana. Yeah, remastered are pretty sweet. While you do what? Go down with the ship? In a manner of speaking. The object we found, I'm gonna try and land the Autumn on it. With all due respect, sir, this war has enough dead heroes.
I appreciate your concern, Cortana, but it's not up to me. Protocol is clear. Destruction or capture of a shipboard AI is absolutely unacceptable, and that means you're leaving the ship. Lock in a selection of emergency landing zones, upload them to my neural lace, and then sort yourself for a hard transfer. Aye, aye, sir. Sort yourself for that hard transfer.
Which is where you come in, Chief. Get Cortana off this ship. Keep her safe from the enemy. If they capture her, they'll learn everything. Force deployment, weapons research, Earth.
I understand. Hey, Artistic, welcome. The Autumn will continue. I'm about to put a blue lady inside me. Not
that
you'll listen, but I'd
suggest letting my subroutines handle. That is technically true.
Yeah.
Excellent work, Cortana. Thank you.
It's consensual.
Every member of the UNSC has a neural interface as soon as they enlist.
Oh, jeez. So everybody can jack in?
Yeah. They're, the UNSC is
amoral. Yeah.
We're going to talk about them a lot. I wouldn't even call them amoral. I would call them objectively bad guys.
Don't get any funny ideas. Old graphics, holy bejesus. What's happening? New graphics.
Oh yeah, so this is
That's cool.
I'm gonna regret showing you this, but if you come over here.
Yeah.
This is the first of the terminals that you can activate.
Okay.
And so if you activate this, it'll play you a little cutscene about
sweet.
In regards to a character that you have not met yet.
Warning. By okay. Order of the Human Council, proximity to Installation 04.
And you hate Assassin's Creed?
Your continued presence will result in most unpleasant countermeasures. I must insist that you immediately change course and return to a minimum safe distance of 1 light year.
Yeah, I have cutscenes, but not in the game itself. Okay.
This has served as your one and final warning. I have activated defensive systems, and you now have 30 seconds to return to the minimum safe distance of... Wait. Curious. Curious indeed, after all these years. Greetings, humans, and welcome to Installation 04.
Huh.
Ignore prior warnings, and please continue. I have disabled defensive systems to allow your approach, but you must not exit your ship once you have arrived at the designated landing center. This ring contains significant dangers, and even with your assumed legacy, I must verify the presence and pitch of your Gaia before allowing full access. We have much to discuss, humans. I have been away far too long.
What?
You have been away far too long.
What? This is... What?
Yeah, you're basically not going to understand any of that. We'll talk about that later. That's 343 Guilty Spark, who you're not supposed to have met yet. We'll get to him.
Oh, God, it's happening again. How do I...
What is
it? No, I launched it. Oh, God. How do I...
It's probably spacebar.
All right, there we go.
I use a controller.
There you go. Yeah, you're a controller. I'm Wazd. Well, no, I'm not Wazd. Hey, bada bada. Pistol kill. Die.
Now, what is incredible about Halo, as opposed to, like, newer generation games...
Yeah.
Is, where are you?
I'm here. I'm shooting the dudes. Come on.
I'm trying to walk up to you to show you something.
Well, okay. Here. Fine.
Stop moving.
I'm done. God damn it. What are you doing?
Would you stop moving? Anyway, that works. Friendly fire's on. Now I had your gun. That's what's important.
I hate you.
We'll come back. It's fine.
Old graphics. Old crappy graphics for Pat. Boo. A million times boo. How do I respawn?
There have to be no enemies.
Well, cool. So
yeah, listen, this is a did you think you were gonna get to play? That's not right.
Hold on. Yeah. Hold on though. So what you're telling me, Pat, is that we could waste the entire game doing this.
Very much so. Yeah, we're going to have to make the decision as a team to move forward. Now, hang on. I think we got off on the wrong foot.
No, I'm digging this now. I like this now. This is good. This works for me. I'm feeling better. All right, are you back yet?
But yeah, watch out for that, though, because... you can accidentally just, like, decimate your pals in old Halo. And in new Halo. And just in Halo in general. There's friendly fire.
I don't have the regular pistol anymore. I only have the alien one. Where's the regular one?
Oh, that's okay. The alien one is very good. So the alien one... I went the wrong way. The alien pistol automatically drops shields if you charge it up. So if you hold the button and release, it'll pop the shields off of the elites.
popping
the elites
shields.
Are the tiny guys, and the grunts are little tiny ones that say funny things.
Yeah,
they're
like
Ellie or Ungoy, depending on.
They are what? Repeat that.
Yeah. So they have alien names for their alien language, and they are known as either Sangheili, which are the elites, or Ungoy, who are the grunts.
Got it.
And their religious based alien war society has a caste
system.
As you do. And so the elites are pretty high up the echelon. They're the defenders of the prophets, or the Sanshayun, who you will not meet for some time.
Okay. Makes total sense.
Yeah, the Ungoy grunts, those are, they're sort of like cannon fodder.
And, yeah, they definitely feel like it.
Yeah, recently due to a rebellion that they had on their planet, where half their planet did need to get glassed to teach them a lesson, they are now allowed to carry weapons into combat. That's what they got.
Oh, so they used to just literally be meat shields that ran forward.
Right. Now, the weird thing about the Ungoy is that the lore that does exist on them spends a concerning amount of time talking about the birth rates among the Ungoy, which is a really strange thing for your lore to focus on, I think.
I get weirded out by that. They do that with orcs in D&D, and they're like, orcs hump a lot.
Well, like,
Orcus
yeah, I mean,
makes
like,
them.
The Ungoys have been under a lot of stress, and so their population...
I mean, they need release.
Yeah, they needed these sweet guns.
I mean, if you're not... given guns, the only thing you can do is, like, demand sex all the time.
They also live on a giant ice planet and routinely freeze to death. Oh, yeah, so you probably got teleported up there a second ago.
I did.
Yeah, so the checkpoint system in original Halo is terrible. And, so,
and it's just gonna pop me?
It does pull you to where you need to be sometimes. So whoever is in front is gonna like yank the other person forward. It is extremely disorienting.
It's gonna be me being yanked by you 100% every time. I'm gonna get like glitches in the Matrix.
The assault rifle
is fun.
It's
so
stupid.
Good
in this game. And it will never be good again, so enjoy it while it is good. Because as we progress through all the other games, it will never be like this ever again.
But there are other guns.
There are other guns, but none of them are the assault rifle.
The assault rifle is, like, the most unfair thing I have ever encountered in a video game.
Yeah, this is heroic, but I mean, admittedly, it's not legendary, and it's certainly not legendary all skulls on, but...
Oh, I just took a lot of damage. Jeez.
Yeah, the red elites are not joking.
All right, hold on. I gotta go do that shit.
Oh yeah, this game also has health packs, and you should shoot this guy.
Yeah. I figured. I remember enough.
That will go away eventually, and then come back at some point. Covenant. It's weird. On the landing above us. But we have health packs and shields in this one because, in lore, your Mark V armor here, you're basically strapped into a miniaturized starship.
Wow. Yeah, which, Cortana said my architecture was similar to this place.
Yeah, so you have, like, shielding tech based on Covenant shields. Like, the elites obviously have shields, but you'll notice that, like, none of the human grunts around here have shields.
Well, I figured they're not the main character. So.
They're not the main character, but story-wise is what I'm telling you.
Okay.
It is because this armor is very expensive, and they've only made like 60 of the suits at this point. As the lore goes forward, basically everyone and also their grandmother basically gets a suit. But for now, they're rare and special. They're also extremely dangerous. You are also a
Is this like the knockoff Iron Man armor that like twists people in half?
Yes. In addition to this very fancy armor.
Oh god, I threw a grenade.
Yeah, that's a bad place to put that.
I did it.
You also got this like cool like Captain America style like explorative surgery and gene therapy to make you better at killing things.
Yeah. I'm like a less openly fascistic space marine.
Not less openly. Did you kill me?
I think I might have.
Yes, you did. You punched me in the back of the head. I just watched you do it on the Twitch.
Hold on. Let me talk to the chat real quick. Yes, Redbeard, this is the inaugural Halo stream that I promised for a long, long time. And Werecat, to answer your question, I believe Pat is the Master Chief, and I am the not-quite-Master Chief.
That's not quite true. You see, in later games, they're going to, like, introduce, like, other side characters that we play as. Okay. But here in Halo CE, as you can see, we are both just Master Chief.
Okay.
There's just two Master Chiefs, and that's what's happening.
And because I host, I'm the Master Chief.
But I'm also here, and I'm also the Master Chief.
But I know right now, but I'm saying in future games.
Oh, yeah. In future games, when there is an option to not be Master Chief, I will end up not being Master Chief. But we'll get into that, and I can't really tell you who those people are, because that's spoilers.
All right. Fair enough.
Oh yeah, this is like unnecessarily confusing. They want you to learn how to use your flashlight, so learn how to use your flashlight. It has batteries that drain in this game for some
reason. Okay, it's like Half-Life.
It's not gonna come up very much, frankly.
Hello.
What are you doing? You're going the wrong way. We need to go this way.
I was following you, and then things got jumpy.
Yeah, this is what I. This yeah, exactly. It got very confused.
Well, Pat's the one that made sure that friendly fire was on. He was like, play heroic.
That has nothing to do with heroic. Friendly fire is just always on in this game.
Oh. Well.
I can kill you no matter what setting you put it on.
That's good. Metro does that. That's on my very long
to play
list.
Now we're up here, you can see the elites came down here trying to find us.
Yeah, look at them. Dumb idiots.
You know, I don't remember. So I remember that in Halo CE, all of the skulls are really hard to find.
Skulls?
I don't. Yeah, so here, I'll explain that in a second. So if you come over here, there's a fun little Easter egg, though. So
Yeah.
Over here, you can see these readouts on the wall. Uh-huh. And so one of them is you, one of them is John117, and the other one over here is Linda, who is another Spartan 2.
Yeah.
And she's off doing something at this point in the story, which is why she's not here. But she was originally the other person. That's why they had two of the little caskets down there. Though, if you switch back to the old graphics, you'll see that this Easter egg is not here. And so, much like many of the things in the Haloverse, they've sort of just retconned a lot of things afterwards. A lot of the timelines in the book
Look at that.
Don't line up.
That's bullshit. All right, let's go.
And the thing about all the other Spartans is that most of them have very open-ended stories so that they never actually have to kill any of these Spartans. They're sort of like Schrodinger's cat. It's like all of the other Spartans are somehow, at the same moment, dead and very much alive doing other Spartan things, depending on if they have written a book about them yet.
Interesting, because... I think we go the other way.
Are we going the other way? We're going the wrong way. I got killed by a wall, so I got confused.
I think we go here, because I said so. Yep.
That doesn't seem right. That is right. But yeah, so skulls. So in every Halo level, there is a skull that you can pick up as if it were a gun.
Okay.
And
even this level?
Yep, and it unlocks like an effect or something that the game can do later. Hang on, don't push me out.
Yeah.
It's bad time.
Yeah.
I have to bop this guy. Okay, now you can. Yeah, so I don't remember where the skull is or how you get it. In this Halo, the skulls are very difficult to actually locate and pick up and typically require some pretty extensive grenade jumping to get to where they are.
Grenade jumping?
Yes, that's, I mean, as you might expect, it's where you jump and throw a grenade down so that the grenade fires you to where you're trying to go to.
Wow.
Yeah, there's most of them, if I recall, or many of them, I should say, require you to do some fancy footwork. Though I don't remember exactly where those are. If I remember where they are, I'll try and look it out.
Good thing I'm on keyboard.
Mostly they do things that you won't want to enact your first time playing through the game anyway. For instance, they will do... so they'll do things like they'll turn off your HUD, or they'll make enemies super strong or something.
Okay,
so like
they're modifiers.
Yeah, there's a couple of them that are like fun little cool things. Like the birthday party grunt skull is always a fun one, because every time you get a headshot on a grunt, they explode into confetti. The I would have been your daddy skull is also very good, though I don't remember if that one is in Halo CE or if it comes later. But that one makes characters say... like the rarer, so like all of the lines that the NPCs are saying are like randomly chosen to be played, and so the I would have been your daddy one makes the more rare ones pop up more frequently. So for instance, I can't actually hear the game at the moment, so I don't know if he's talking, but I believe in this hallway right here, this is the first time that you can run into Chips Dubbo, who is one of these Marines with an Australian accent, and he shows up in every single Halo game and says some funny lines, even though because some of the games overlap with each other, he does happen to be in two places at once somehow. Chips Dubbo is an enigma. I don't remember.
Interesting. All right. Well, we're going forward. This is backwards.
I'm not exactly wrong. This level.
Hey, bada bada.
Hey, there we go. No. That's it. Yeah, that level is a little confusing. Good time to leave. Always.
Punch it.
This is a Bumblebee class escape carrier. They are designed exclusively to crash land. We're gonna make
it, aren't we, sir? I don't wanna die out here. Then why do all these guys get absolutely wrecked?
Yeah, so here's the thing. There is basically in all of the Halo games not a single safe landing, and if a Marine gets into a dropship, they're pretty much dead.
Which is why you play one in ODST. That's the joke. It's your red shirt.
Technically, you play an ODST in ODST, which is different. We'll talk about that later.
An orbital dropship trooper. I knew that.
Well, drop shock trooper.
Shut up. I mean, thank you.
One of the fun things about this scene is that everybody else is, like, strapped into, like, 5-cord harnesses.
And then you're just holding on.
Casually leaning against the chair.
Yeah, he's just like, whatever.
Because his armor is made of starship materials, he has re-entry capabilities. Again, we'll get to that later.
Wow.
If I still had fingers, they'd be crossed.
He's his own spaceship.
He's literally his own spaceship.
That's...
He doesn't have FTL.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
You know, we can always improve in different ways.
Yeah. He needs to be able to fold space.
We're coming in too fast. I don't remember if they fold space. I think they do fold space, because that's... Yeah, they fold space. It's a thing. I don't want to get into it. We'll get into it a little bit later in each.
That's going to be what a lot of it is. I'm losing the thing designed to crash. Oh, no.
Chief, can you hear me?
Yes, Blue Lady. Right?
Can you move?
Uh-huh.
The others.
My sound is still not back. That's fine. I guess I just don't get to hear Halo this game. I don't need it. It does mean that I literally can't hear when people are talking.
Put subtitles on.
Oh, that's a good idea. We should follow me, and then I will put subtitles on. Because we don't want to be standing here.
I recommend moving into those
being
hills.
Spoken to.
If we're lucky, the Covenant will believe that everyone aboard this lifeboat died in a crash. Alert, Covenant dropship inbound. They must be looking for survivors. I recommend immediate evasion.
I'm going to hide behind this rock. I'm going to try to hide. Is there an invisible wall here?
Kind
of. Oh, no, there's a very real wall here if you go back to the old graphics.
Yeah, I just checked.
That's very funny.
Werecat, you're right. Except if I was my own grandpa, I would be immune to the giant brains. So, you know, pros and cons. Ow. Dickbag. What a jerk. Stop it. Stop it!
Yeah, I'm gonna let you deal with that. I'm trying to remember where the subtext is.
Wait, I gotta deal with it? Ow. Yeah. Fuck that. I'm gonna die. Oh, wait. God, I hate this.
Oh, okay.
No! Go away!
For some reason, I made my game closer. But I can live with that for the moment. Your pistol is probably the best use here if you recall.
Okay. Yeah. Pistol. Sniper. Ow, my face. Holy fuck. Okay. I didn't know I was supposed to. Sometimes there's shit in video games that's like, they just hurt you and they're part of the background.
No, the Banshee you can very much kill.
Okay. I was getting a little salt from Salty, one of my audience people out in internet land.
See what I'm doing? Off we go. Oh boy, where have you gone? There you are. Okay,
I'm right behind you.
This is one of like the first. So Halo was really cool for consoles. I mean, like it was one of the first really.
I remember Xbox One. I mean, the original, not the Xbox One.
Or the Xbox One S, or the One XS.
Yeah.
Or the Supreme Rap Crunch Show.
Wow, what? Their naming conventions are shit.
they're all over the place. But among them, they have, every now and then, they just nail some really cool level designs. And so, this one is one of the first experiences I can remember where you kind of get put in a sandbox and you're sort of allowed to choose the direction you can go. Now, by today's standards, it's not going to be that crazy.
No.
But at the time, it was really sweet because what's going to happen here is like we're crash landing all over the Halo, this ring in the sky. We haven't even talked about in Halo. I've been telling you all of this lore.
No. I knew there were circles involved. That I was a green guy and that there are circles. I was positive about that.
So we're crash landing all over this thing.
So we got life signs, though. We got to go.
Right. So we need to go find these downed bumblebee escape pods.
All right. We got to go rescue all the red shirts. Got it.
And defend them. But you can sort of choose, not right now, not just yet, but it'll get to the point where you can sort of choose what order you choose to go and rescue folks.
Yeah, you got to play everything, but not in order.
Not in order.
Or a which particular is, order. So that's kind of...
It's cool. A theme that you're going to see repeated at least one point every game.
Interesting. I don't know where you are.
I climbed up the building.
Why?
Because there's guns and ammo up here, of course.
Oh. Oh. I wish I had a sprint.
You do not have a sprint yet.
I won't for all of this game, right? Stay here.
Guns, man, on earth. Behind Jari.
Heads up! I got a coveted drop ship heading in. Over here!
So now these drop ships come down.
And we get fucked.
You know, I don't remember what the official name for this style of drop ship is. Because I know the other ones are called Phantoms.
Wow, look at that.
But I presume that these
the skybox are... is crazy.
Oh, yeah. Swapping between the graphics at every point is kind of cool. Hey, the first jackals are here, too.
Oh, wow. I don't like them.
Also known as the Kig-Yar. So they've got these, like, little shields that they carry around with them, which are very frustrating. But you can, with your pistol, you can shoot their hand, and then they'll put up the shield, and then you can pop them once in the head.
So they're like
phalanx. You can also overload an energy pistol, and it'll. I think it'll drop their shield in this one.
I'm gonna make a lot of Destiny like parallels.
Well, that's the other cool thing that you'll be able to see is, you can playing through these games. You can definitely see how Halo became Halo. And yes, in this level, you can definitely blast. I'm seeing the chat now. You can definitely blast through and just not save the Marines. I don't remember if those have health. I bet the turrets have health. but I think a lot of vehicles, well, I know a lot of vehicles in Halo CE are indestructible. The Covenant ones tend not to be, but I can't remember if the dropships are also indestructible or if they can be blown up with enough ammo. It would definitely be hard to do with an assault rifle in a pistol, but that's definitely a way for a rocket.
Ah, I'm glad I died! Avenge me, was... Master Chief!
Okay, let me see what I can do.
You're pretty masterful about that. I'm back already. I mean, I'm teabagging myself. Look at that. We can all do it. You think you're special?
It's early 2000 ceiling. Again, I don't know what you're talking about.
So were you regressing to the age you were when you played this initially?
That is 100% true. I was a in Halo 3, I was the guy that if I couldn't grab the sniper rifle in time, I would stand in front of you and try and get you to shoot me in the head so that I could boot you so that I could have the sniper rifle. Because I was
Jesus
like 14
Christ,
and a bad
Pat.
Person. I'm not like that anymore.
No.
That was a bad.
You're better.
Mm.
You
so what
deal
I found out
with
there,
me.
Is that I'm dead. You should probably get out of the middle of danger.
Why?
Well, because you're probably going to die.
No, I'm not. Have faith.
So the grenades on the ground, more so in this Halo than the other Halos, have a tendency to just explode and wreck you. And that's like dud grenades on the ground. You can set them off with other grenades.
Got it.
Oh!
Right,
what? First the Needlers. So this thing is the Needler, which is also ridiculously overpowered in Halo CE.
It's
bonkers. I'm up on the building. There's little icons for me.
Yeah, I see you. Okay.
It shoots auto-tracking rounds that sort of like seek their target, and they deal damage when they hit you, and then they explode. And if you stack enough of them, they explode like a grenade and like auto-kill.
That's really cool. You're a cool guy now.
They
blow
are
up.
Less effective in other Halos. Did you say level up?
I said blow up. I'm throwing grenades.
There's no level system. Hey, Echo 419 is here. Echo 419 is also known as Fohammer, and she's going to be our ride to grab this. But not right now. Right now she's going to pick up these guys.
Fohammer.
Where is she? She lands in this canyon somewhere.
Look, more lifeboats.
She's right there.
Coming in fast. Those lifeboats make it down, the Covenant are going to be right on top of them.
Fohammer, we need you to disengage your Warthog. The Master Chief and I are going
Warthog.
Save some soldiers.
I watch Red versus Blue.
Roger, Cortana.
There you go. That is, in fact,
okay,
a Warthog.
Okay, Charlie Team, Warthog deployed. Saddle up and give them hell.
No, no.
Roger, Fohammer.
Don't trust me with this power.
Alright, do you want to drive or do you want to shoot?
That's
shoot. You drive.
Echo 419.
These things are so slidey in this game.
Yeah, that's why I'm making you do it.
Okay, so it is this thing is indestructible, so
yep.
It will not blow up. We can be killed though,
yep.
While we're driving very easily, and you are never going to run out of ammo. So don't
Sweet.
Worry about that.
I'm very excited.
Oh right, it's very rolly. It is extremely rolly. They're always pretty rolly. Okay, well thank you.
Okay.
We're off to a fabulous
hold on, hold
start.
On, hold on, huh? There we go. Yeah, just gotta once or twice. Deserved it. All right. Look.
Okay. There we go. Yeah. So this is what I mean. Like you can see, like as I'm turning, this thing just slides all over the place.
Kind of like
they're
the Mako.
Always pretty. they're always very slidey, but they are like in this game they are the most slidey and the most tippy. Okay, so that's like
we gotta we
I'm
gotta
going like
get
40
more,
miles an hour and it's
we
like
gotta
ready
get
to up
more headlight itself. Fluid man.
This cave is not a natural formation.
Thank you, Cortana.
Someone built it, so it must lead.
I know that.
What?
Figure that out.
Someone built this?
Even in the old graphics, it doesn't look anything like a natural cave. It's like, why would you? Okay.
Show them who they're dealing with.
I mean, no.
Master Chief, I'm going to use your suit's transcom system to monitor their chatter.
Okay, so that glowy light right there, that is your next cutscene.
Cool. I'm getting out. I'm gonna go cut some scenage. I can't sprint.
You're crouching, dude. You're doing this the slowest possible way. You're like on your hands and knees climbing over to the computer panel.
Alright, character I don't know.
I am experiencing such a mixture of anticipation and dread. All preparations are complete for my installation.
Space starfish.
The final dictum of the enemy council.
Boy, it really just shows a whole bunch of stuff you have no context for.
My former station. This was not difficult. What was could never be again.
Yeah, the collector's edition is a really weird way to play this the first time. Or the remastered.
Prior I love
to my
it.
Final journey through the Great Portal, a gathering of my fellow monitors was convened upon the Lightworkers'
Oh, fuck me. These are the ghosts.
Index collection.
From Destiny.
Yeah, dude. No new ideas.
It was most unusual.
And still, circles. Destiny's about a circle, too. Circles versus pyramids.
Destiny's about a sphere. Get it right.
Lightworkers were responsible for getting us to our places on the active facilities of the
world. They added a whole new dimension.
While all of this was in accordance with the plan, one entirely unsatisfactory breakdown remained. We had no contact with the domain.
Oh, not the domain.
The history of all forerunners was now lost to us.
Oh, shit.
We relied upon the permanence of the domain to preserve our record of the events that led to this point. But without that record, would future civilizations know anything about us?
We'll talk about what any of this means later. You're missing a lot of key information at this moment.
My fellow monitor, 049 Abject Testament, had only one.
Yeah, I feel like I walked in on like the 10th season of a Star Trek show I've never watched. We deserve to be forgotten.
The portal opens, and through it, the familiar shape awaits. Halo.
Circles.
Home.
Circle home. I should have just called this stream Circles.
Get in.
We're gonna do that a lot.
I think it might give you a score too at the end of each level. We'll find out for sure.
I don't give a shit.
Do a jumpy jump. Okay.
Tokyo Drift like this thing, shit.
Like, that's like Tokyo Drift is just how it turns. All right, shoot all this stuff, please. There's really no I would like to not drift option here. If you're not out of control, you're not in control, is that the one?
I mean,
I'm certainly out of control, let me tell you.
It is making this interesting.
Just shoot them.
Okay. Thank you.
Well, listen, you have an infinite number of bullets.
I do. I do not. We're going to be here all night. Well, right now, this stream's called Chief Mastery with Pat.
I would not say anything along those lines. Okay, that should be all of them. So I'm just gonna go up here and here, hit a button. You do not need to hop out if you do not want to. Boy, I can talk at the moment. Oh wait, you might need to hop out. Oh boy.
Good thing I didn't listen to you.
Yeah, there are two red elites up there. Okay, now I'm gonna go press the button.
I want to watch you press the button. I'm excited. Oh man, these are not natural cave networks.
Yeah, unbelievable, right? Oh, the Banshees are much easier to drive. They can explode, however, unlike the Warhogs, which can just easily turn over at this point.
Laser bridge. No game's complete without a laser bridge.
I just walked off the edge of the map.
Ha ha. Dumb.
They should really put a handrail up here or something.
You're dumb.
Listen, I said I played a lot of these games, not that I was exceptionally good at these games.
I'm not better. You're definitely still better. What? Okay, no, wait. Don't kill me. Just...
You better move quick.
I did. OSHA violation. Ugh.
This whole place is an OSHA violation. That's why the Forerunners fell. They didn't have OSHA.
So this is a Forerunner joint?
Oh, yeah.
Are they
this very naturally forming ring out in space?
A lot more crew made it off the Autumn than I had predicted. The captain really gave them hell. If we can find Captain Keyes and the other survivors, we have a chance to coordinate an effective resistance.
See, he's really the key.
They were like, Captain Key did such a good job fighting all these guys, but in the lore, all of the aliens were afraid that they would break the Halo ring if they, like, shot bullets and accidentally
hit. So they, like, took it easy.
They didn't know, they just didn't shoot at him, except for one guy who disobeyed orders. You'll meet him later. It's okay, none of that actually comes up in the game, though. I don't think anything I've told you thus far comes up at any point in the actual story of the game.
But it's there. It's important.
Bungie has always been excellent at ensuring that their storytelling is told anywhere than in the medium that you are actually attempting to participate.
Right. Like, Destiny has great lore, just not in the game.
Not in Destiny. God, this thing is so hard to drive.
I like making you do it. I like watching.
I mean, you're gonna tip
it. Oh, God. Oh, God.
So yeah, this is the point like where you can just sort of explore and you can travel in different directions and find different groups of Marines.
All right, let's get the Marines. Let's get them.
Just pick one. Just pick one and go to it.
We gotta save them all. They're like Pokemon to me. Understand?
We gotta save them all now so they can die later.
Yeah. Like Pokemon.
They made the mistake of surviving the drop pod.
See, what they should have done was die on the spaceship. That would have been better.
I also don't remember. So, overcharged plasma pistols can disable vehicles. They just stop them from running for a few seconds. I don't remember if that's true in Halo CE, though. I think it is definitely true for the Banshees, at least. And so I would assume it's also true for Ghosts and the Wraiths, but I don't remember if that works on Warthogs here. Oh, we're going to flip. Get ready to get out and shoot. Oh, maybe not. We're okay.
Well, I'm not okay. My shield's down.
Yeah, I can. Don't worry. I can see your health in the gunner position.
Oh, we got Greg in the chat. How's it going, Greg? I am learning the ways of Master Chief, and so far it's.
So far we've mostly killed each other. So that's
yeah.
That's actually
we've spent
good.
Most of this game shooting each other.
I need you to keep shooting the gun, though.
Why?
Yeah, I know your buddy's here. But you're
I
on
was
the
all
turret.
Excited. Yeah, Greg, we're going until... We got another couple hours. We're going until 10. I'm taking a break at some point because I will have dinner. but I'll eat in like 5 minutes and then I'll come back. It's just spaghetti.
Oh, don't get run over, please. Okay.
We're all fine. Right,
so these are the Marines.
I'm great.
Okay, I can just get in control of this for a second.
Thank you, Greg.
I'll call in a dropship to pick
hop
them up.
Out here.
I'm gonna hop out here too, but so because I sniper, want to.
There's a sniper on the gun on the ground that you should try. I think there might be a second one that I can find.
Yeah, there is.
It is not as good of a sniper as the pistol, but it is just very good.
Oh God!
If you hit with it, it will not leave
fuck this
behind.
Thing. I don't want it. I want the other gun. Give me the pistol. Oh God! What awfulness! I don't want that. I hate sniper rifles.
Did you drop on the ground?
I didn't. I can, but oh wait! I want the needle. There we go. Give me that. Gimme.
Where did you put the power weapon? Because I'm gonna pick it up if you put it on the ground. Okay.
I like this better.
It keeps so many bullets.
Yeah, Greg, this is the remaster of Halo 1. This is the furthest I've been in Halo. I feel like Samwise Gamgee. This is the furthest way I've ever been from home.
If you switch over now, you can see like they actually had color in the old version of the game, which
Let's
they did
sure
remove on
the
remaster.
Give me more of that.
Let's see. Now this isn't Johnson's group. I think he's the next group that we'll find.
Oh, well. Gotta get Johnson. I haven't played that yet. How is it? Among Us, Greg.
Oh, that's that delightful little social sci-fi social.
Yeah.
I don't know anything about this. We need to get back to our ride. We're on our way.
All right. Back to the big pig. Sometimes it's very good. So it's like life. Its glow will not last. It's coming down. Oh, you sound like you're doing a good job right there. Alright.
Dang it.
What? Why am I riding on the... Fuck that. No! You... Ooh, you dirty rat. Go!
Come on, just get in the gun.
Oh, come on. Come on. Ah!
Okay, there we go. Now you can get on the gun.
No!
Come on, man. I'm not even messing with you this time.
Yeah.
I
wish I could shoot you.
Hold on. Find some more.
You know, I'm glad friendly fire's in this. I'm glad now.
You will become glad of it. Oh, God.
This is...
These things are just uncontrollable.
This is a silly game.
You know what's wild, too, is there's going to be a later level where we have to drive this thing on ice, and it's even harder to control.
Oh, Werecat, we're not being tested. You should see us when we do a Destiny raid. This is nothing.
This is it.
Survivors detected. Marines are concealed in those rocks.
Gun guy?
Oh, hi. I was reading the chat. I don't know if you know this, but like,
we just,
I'm
like,
streaming.
Pull up and park. We park next to the Covenant. And like, we're just sitting there and I'm like, looking back at you like,
I'm the most Zen Master Chief you've ever met.
I think we've only accidentally managed to kill each other once when Ari punched me in the back of the head.
Yeah,
I mean,
that was accidental. But then we, yeah, no, purposeful, spiteful, one might say.
So, Sergeant Avery Johnson, who we're about to meet, we can't actually take the car up through here, so we should. I mean, you can. You can take the cars anyway, but it'll be really hard to get out of there. So,
okay,
just up in the rock for Marines.
But we got to go get Johnson.
Yeah, so he is
without you, Johnson.
A Spartan 1, which wasn't called Spartan 1.
Shut up.
It was called the Orion Project. And they were like recruits that agreed to have all the weird super soldier testing done on them.
Okay.
And it's really unclear with his backstory what his deal is, because like the cover story for him getting these like augmentations was some disease that I forget the name of, like some made up space disease that was supposedly he got it from using Covenant weapons too much and the radiation like gave him this degenerative disease, but really what they were doing was like giving him super strength. But
so it's all a cover up, man.
Later on it then will also say that he does actually have that disease that is supposedly fake and made up, so who knows.
Wow.
But you'll see him a lot. He's around.
All right.
His origin story is very different than yours.
Right.
Master Chief is the real victim of the Halo series. Because all the Spartan 2s, boy, this is like, where do I even start? So before the Covenant showed up and we started having war, humanity was dealing with this just like general group that they call the Insurrectionists, who were not happy that Earth was like deciding all of the laws and overseeing the colonies. The colonies felt that like Earth didn't have the right to tell them what to do, because they're like, well, they're like a little bit fascist and kind of shitty. And so I guess to like prove that they're like super not fascist and shitty, the UNSC did then go and kidnap a bunch of 10-year-old children from the colonies and flash clone them, and then replace the kids with flash clones who were all like designed to die of like horrible diseases over the course of next year, thus like destroying about 100 families in the process. And they then did take those kids and indoctrinate them, and then on their 14th birthday just like jam them up full of like drugs and crazy surgery to make Spartan 2s, which is who you are.
Okay, so I was right. We're Space Marines. This is Warhammer. We're playing Warhammer.
I mean, not no. Like, it's weird because, like, again, it's one of those things that they just don't really talk about in this here actual game, Halo. But you were kidnapped as a kid and, like, psychologically abused and experimented on.
Maybe like Warhammer 9K, 7K.
But okay, but here's the wild thing, right? So like you might be tempted to say like, well, yes, but we needed these super soldiers to defeat these terrible aliens that were coming.
Right.
Except there were no aliens when
It was to me to get the insurrectionists.
they hadn't met the aliens. So Master Chief was built, they built crazy
to kill
super
humans.
Soldiers just to kill like normal people who were like, hey,
I don't feel like this
government should have a role over me.
He went through like spec ops
and
training.
And then we'll meet Halsey eventually. And we'll talk about the doctor that did all this. But her whole thing is like, well, the means justifies when she is eventually put on war crimes, on trial for war crimes, because you know, if you do separate children from their families, eventually you will be tried for war crimes.
Really?
I am just talking about Halo and nothing else. It may take a long time. It sure does in Halo. It takes years before they get to the point that they say, hey, separating children from their families and then causing, you know, psychological damage to them. That's a crime against humanity, and you do need to answer for that.
Oh, well, we don't have to do that now in 2020, right?
Yeah, thankfully this is not something that we need to worry about at the moment.
We're not separating people from their families. You know, that doesn't happen. Not in America.
Justice does tend to arc around. Anyway, yeah, it's pretty bonkers.
There's our car.
Master Chief here doesn't have a great life.
Yeah, you tell me, man.
I would love this not to be the case. Okay, or I'll die. That's fine, too.
Like I said, Pat is here to make this more than me making fun of the little alien guys because they're dumb looking.
And I do, I like, so here's the thing. We I have learned that there is a portion of my brain that is unfortunately devoted to absorbing all of the weirdo facts about this game because it came at... I played Halo at one of those, you know, like, times in my life where
formative,
you just suck up information.
Formative moments.
Yeah. But I would not even say that I am, like, a hardcore Halo fanboy. Like, I have not read all of the 40 or whatever novels that exist now and probably hundreds of comic books. There is one Red Elite down here.
Yep.
Who keeps just coming out of nowhere and messing with me and then running away. Come back. Okay, see, he keeps dragging me into, like, these full health other Covenant guys who then I have to stop and fight. This Elite is good at Halo. He's good at the game with his apartment. Okay, he's dead. And now I'm on the turret. That's not where I want
to
be.
Echo 419 to Cortana. Bohammer's on station and ready for
another pickup. Okay, so now she's coming for a pickup.
Affirmative, Bohammer. We're ready for dust-off. Approach when ready.
I have trouble getting back to my car.
We're going to look for the last light.
Thank you,
Juan.
Oh yeah, you're still doing your hydrate and stuff?
Oh, I love that shit. My power level. That's what I call channel points here. Nobody renames their stuff. Oh, for subscribers, information that you would probably find prudent. I've submitted emotes. They are pending approval. So we got emotes on the way. Once we're done rescuing the next group of people, we'll take a quick bio break.
All right, I think it's time to hydrate.
Yeah, it is.
Make sure that you take a good sip like I am.
You found my fucking water bottle, didn't you? God, I hate you. Well, Jasmine bought me a new one. So, true story.
Do you remember we left that here before?
True story.
We had a global pandemic.
So, like, a long time ago, back in 2019, I think, I was over Pat's apartment because we actually live walking distance from each other, if we're willing to brave the plague, and I left my water bottle after a day of games, and then...
It is phenomenal for hydrating.
It is. It's a great water bottle. I was really upset.
Good news is the captain is
fine. I mean, again, Greg, I don't know if I have the same audio standards as you. Oh, I can guarantee I don't. But the monitoring isn't bothering me. I really don't hear. It's like, if I'm using film terms, it's like maybe a frame or half a frame off. Maybe. But it's pretty immediate. Like, I hear the tiniest of echoes, but I hear myself talking. And it's not asynchronous to the point that I can't concentrate. So yeah, Pat has my water bottle now. My old one. He's had it for a year.
Get the job done.
And you're right, it's a great fucking water bottle. I was missing it.
We can make it. Oh boy, that's a grenade. That's gonna be a problem.
Really? It's slowing me down? Weird. I feel like I'm talking the same, but... Again, as you joked, Greg, you said I was high and, you know, weed happened.
Okay, we got hit by a charged plasma blast and it didn't seem to cut my engine. So.
Do I talk really fast as Mr. Friend? I don't know.
Okay, that's a lot of bleeds. Oh,
it's probably the weed, dude.
You're crouched again, Ari.
Hey! I meant to do that. I meant to do that, too.
Ari! Ari! Okay.
Hey! What's up?
Wait, where are we? Okay, here we go. That's what I get from
this. Well, you're right, Greg. The NSA does really care about what I'm doing on Twitch right now. Thank you,
yeah, you're
Salty.
Only playing this, you're only streaming this game, what, 20 years out of date?
Right?
I think it is actually something like that.
Yeah, nope. I was about 13 when Halo came out. That sounds right.
I was definitely not old enough to play Halo when Halo came out.
No, I was exactly the target audience for Halo, but I was a PlayStation man. I didn't ascribe to anything not Sony. Thus, me playing Destiny and now this shit. Yeah, totally, man. Bruh. I don't say bruh too much. This is a very bro-y game, though.
Yeah, you're gonna start now. So that's the thing, is you've started playing Halo, so bro will slowly enter your vernacular. You're gonna get
I'm not playing Gears of War.
We will be playing Gears of War next. You heard it here first.
Fuck. Do they even have that on PC?
Oh, they do, my dude.
Oh,
and it's through the Game Pass.
Oh, fuck.
That game isn't very good. I mean, I've played a lot of it, but, like, okay, let me backtrack that. It's good for what it is, but it is not something that I would ever suggest that you need to go and play. Specifically.
Yeah. You know, maybe if I liked really aggressive muscle dudes yelling at each other with chainsaw swords, not making out.
My favorite thing, so I was playing the real-time strategy Gears of War game that came out not too long ago.
Yeah.
And my favorite thing in the entire world is that they all just have, like, lines that they yell whenever you order them to do things. And when you, like, send them up, sometimes they're like, safety's off or whatever. And I think it is so goddamn funny that in lore in that universe, the guns that have chainsaws on the front half of them have safeties.
Right.
That is,
like,
the funniest thing in the world to me. Like, make sure to engage your safety.
Like, they wear armor that protects their chest and not their arms. And big chainsaw sword guns.
Uh-oh.
Rubber Raggy.
They also have, like, a running joke in that game that anybody who wears a helmet dies.
That's
dumb. Their version of red shirts.
That's dumb. Ow. Not high enough.
Alright. Checkpoint.
Greg, you're not that much older than me. You couldn't have been 19 when it came out. You're like 3 years older than me. I was like 13. You were 16. Oldest.
I mean, I think I was like 10 because we went to my buddy Jeff's house and we played it with his older brother.
Okay, so how old were you in 2001? I was 13. I got the age right. Holy fuck. Nope. Yep. You're a lot older than me. I thought you were 3 years. You're 5 years older than me. Jesus. Alright. That's how much older I am to Pat. I'm 5 years older than Pat.
Is that right? I guess that's right.
I was like 27, 28 when I met you, and you were 23.
Yeah, that's right.
Greg is old. I'm 87.
Listen, these are the hard
numbers.
Hey,
do me a favor. No, don't. I'll find out.
There's a guy on my radar. Are you gonna ask me to kill you?
I was. I was just having a conversation with a friend the other day about, like, the moral value of assisted suicide.
That's the last of them. Roger that. I'm on my way.
You were shooting it, and it was wasting rounds, Marine.
I found Captain Keyes. He's being held on a Covenant cruiser.
Yeah, so now we need to go find our captain, because he went down with a ship and he got captured. Before we abandoned the Autumn.
the Truth and Reconciliation touched down on a desert plateau roughly 300 kilometers.
I also like that the Halo, like, you can look up and you can see all the Halo, but I like that, like, the Halo has, like, different biomes. There's, like, a desert biome and a
Mean, it's a video game. You gotta have the desert level, you gotta have the ice level, you gotta have the jungle level, underwater level.
Well, you do eventually get all of those things, but you won't get them all in this game.
Cody, I was a PlayStation guy, so that this is all news to me.
Yeah, playing it for the first time on a PC with the remastered settings is very strange.
I'm enjoying it. I like being able to flop back and forth.
Yeah, trippy. Like, seeing the way the ships used to look is fascinating.
Yeah, I was the PlayStation guy, which is why I got into Destiny. Because I was like, oh shit, I can play a Bungie game now. I've never been able to do that. I've only, like, played Halo drunk with my friends. Like...
Oh my god.
Loud noises.
I don't know what's going on with the sound. Like, I have the sound in some menus, but in the game itself, I don't actually have sound. I'll fix this.
So how do we get inside the ship if it's in the air? The Corps issued me a rifle, not wings. There's a gravity lift that ferries troops and supplies between the ship and the surface.
You get to meet some new alien types.
Once we get inside the ship, I should be able to lock on to the tracking signal from Captain Key's neural implants.
Alright, before we go forward, let's take a bio break here and come back. This is a checkpoint. Yeah, cool. Alright, so I'll be back. So will Pat. It'll be quick.
Get ready to move in to support us, Sergeant. The Master Chief is going to covertly take out as many of the Covenant as he can. Don't open fire until you hear the enemy return fire on us. That should let us keep the element of surprise.
we're back. Sorry for the delay. I had to be a human and, like, eat some food. It was not just pee. I had to scarf down some pasta.
The enemy has captured Captain Key.
Hey, I have audio now. I fixed it.
Truth and reconciliation.
Big day for me.
Holding position approximately 300 meters above the other end of this plateau.
Thank you. Thank you.
So how do we get inside the ship if it's in the air? The core issued me a rifle.
Now, I know you're such a big fan of the sniper, Ari, so you will be using the sniper from this point on.
Once we get inside the ship, I should be able to lock on to the tracking signal from Captain Key's neural implants.
Because it is the ideal way to play, because it's a sniping mission.
Stick to the higher ground to the right.
Hate it.
Should be able to recon the Covenant position without being spotted. I've detected Covenant stationary guns near the next pass.
Thank you, Greg.
I recommend using your sniper rifle to take out the gunner while I call for Marine support.
Yeah, it's one of those.
The Master Chief is going to covertly take out as many of the Covenant as he can.
I will.
Don't open fire until you hear the enemy return fire on us. That should let us keep the element of surprise.
Let him have it!
Alert! A Covenant is making a run for that stationary gun. Take him out!
I was like, not being able to hold Zoom. Hey, I suck at snipers. Fucking A. Die. Alright.
Just 360 no scope him.
Just 360 no scope. Fuck you. Greg, yeah, this is one of the like glowy frames. It's from Slobs. It's one of their free themes. Because I'm cheap.
How are you still up? Go down.
Yeah, and we're pretty covert. I would agree.
I like if you get them right there, you can just knock them all off the cliff. Because they try and dive away from the grenades. Ow.
I was almost out of lamp juice in my flashlight.
Oh, that's why there's a turret up here. Can you? Okay.
Middle of the screen. Hey. Who said you?
Nope.
Haha. Did not intend that, but it happened. Hey. Nope. That's enough of that.
Boy.
This is some pretty chill combat music.
Oh, yeah. So, be critical of the media you love, you know? I have always been a big fan of this music, however, I cannot enjoy it in the same way that I used to because...
Oh, because he's a douchebag or something?
Yeah, the composer's not great. The music is exceptional, but as a person, he is difficult to reckon with.
Yeah, I feel that way about James Woods. Like, I like him as an actor, but he's a piece of shit.
And it's a shame because it was always one of my favorite parts of the games, was that the music was so well... I mean, like, everybody remembers that, like, that choir kind of, like, startup music at the beginning. Yeah.
It's the only bit of Halo. Nah, I knew
right,
there
like,
were
you've
circles.
Not played Halo, but you know the choir song.
Yeah. I knew it was about circles and a dude named Masters of Chiefs, and he wore green, and he had a blue lady in him.
Hey,
gotcha. I died. Whoa, wow, it's a long way down. That was, oh, wow, look at you drop all your shit. That's so cool.
To walk off the cliff?
Yeah.
Yeah, you don't want to do that.
Hey, Greg. Hey.
There you are.
Hey.
Okay.
You got my attention, Greg. What's up?
Okay.
Cortana to fire.
Boy, he dodges a lot.
Up on the left.
On this difficulty?
Should be able to flank the enemy.
I'm gonna just come up here and punch you.
Oh, alright, cool. Well, I mean, I'm honored. We did. What's the name of the guy who scored this thing?
The composer?
Yeah.
Marty O'Donnell.
We worked with Marty O'Donnell? Who do we know that's Marty O'Donnell? I do not believe... Oh, well, Niall is different. Niall Rogers is the man. Niall Rogers is fucking cool. He's not.
Yeah, I don't know anything.
He's not.
I don't know anything about him. All I know is that, basically, he's just like, at the moment, he is like currently spreading some pretty dangerous ideas about the COVID-19 stuff, which.
Well, that's stupid. Niall Rogers is the. He wrote like everything.
Not, to be clear, Niles Rogers is not doing this. I don't know anything about Niles Rogers.
Niall Rogers,
excuse me.
Fair enough, Greg. You're in and out of the room. I appreciate the hosting. I'm invisible. Can you see me?
Oh, yeah, you picked up a power-up. Yeah, so it has them in a couple of bizarre places where, like, those old video game ideas are still around, so you can, like, pick up a glowy power-up and turn invisible or give yourself an overshield.
But, can I take over the enemy turrets? Oh, yeah, you can.
And I think they might be in the... You're just invisible in a turret. This is extremely funny. Oh, now you're visible.
I can't
so you
get
are gonna
anything.
Be... Go out of that now.
Yeah, I know. I couldn't.
There oh, there's not... a bunch of elites underneath you, actually.
Uh-oh. Hey, fuck off.
Okay.
Don't tread on me.
Well.
Yeah, QAnon cultists, that is what Greg's saying.
I do like the guns have different melee animations.
That is cool.
The sniper does like a really funny like... full butt of the gun. I think they actually do different damage too. I don't know that for certain.
I thought you knew everything, Pat.
Well, listen.
I did say you were the alleged Halo expert. I didn't actually.
I mean, you said that.
Yeah.
I just like playing Halo. I like my good buddy Master Chief.
You, the second Halo got mentioned, you inserted yourself into this stream.
Listen, I like playing Halo. I'm always looking for somebody to play Halo with. Order a big stack of buffalo chicken pizza, crack a few Mountain Dews.
Oh god, I did it again.
Did what? You walked off the cliff again?
Yeah.
It's not even near where the fighting is.
Nah. I found it, though.
It's like a football field away.
If you were looking for the edge of the map, I found it. Now I'm watching you. You're always having some tech emergency, Greg. It sounds very stressful. Oh, you died.
Yep.
Well, that was fun.
Oh, you were dead? Oh, you should have been there. I would not have rushed that position if you were finding you were still dead.
Yeah. There were all those guys there. A Surge soda. I wonder if the chemicals in Surge mean that they never went bad, so that you could, like, if you found on eBay an old bottle of Surge, could you drink it?
Are they not
would
still
you want
producing
to?
Surge?
No, it stopped. It stopped.
Are you sure?
Whoa. Can't hide from me.
Still on, sold in Norway under the name Urge.
Hell yeah.
Greg says he's not joking.
I believe him.
I mean, I'm inclined to believe him too. The man knows about liquids, usually alcoholic ones.
You like that? there we go. Now I'm getting a feel for the sniper again.
Yeah, getting a feel for it. Nice feel.
Covenant dropships are inbound.
I'm getting headshots.
Of internet drink knowledge. Yeah, you are the wiki. I learned this from the comments on my Slurb video. Oh my god. Is there anything, like, left that you haven't done from pop culture? Like, sci-fi drinks? I'll be honest, I'm a bad guy. I don't watch all of Greg's episodes. Just the ones he sends me. He sends me ones by text every once in a while. It's like, hey, watch it. Than I usually do.
I go and I look them up when I need recipes for an existing drink. I don't do some of the more adventurous stuff, especially where things tend to involve fire or liquid nitrogen or a special tool set that I don't have access to, but the basics are real dang good. It's a good solid source.
Ammo.
I'm really low on ammo. I need to find something because we're about to have a problem.
Oh yeah!
These
wow.
Hunters. They're also
are they?
Known the hunters or the Megalic Golo.
The mechanic.
Megalic Golo. I think that's how it's pronounced.
Interesting.
It's a very strange name. They are a bunch of sentient worms.
Oh my god.
They're inside
horrifying.
Of like tank plating with like guns on the front of them or fuel rod cannons built into their arms. They were a real pain.
That was they were gross. That was pretty
gross.
There's
always, there's still one more.
I know.
I'm in a lot of trouble.
I know, I'm trying to find you.
Come on. Okay.
Nope.
Oh, you're a little close. Okay, got it.
Okay.
Alright, there's ammo
Cortana
over here.
Cortana to Echo 419. We've reached the gravity lift and are ready for reinforcements. Copy that, Cortana. Hold tight, gentlemen.
Oh, wow, that looks like crap. That looks awesome.
Once we're inside the
that
ship,
looks like crap.
Yeah, it's really funny when you switch to when they don't have textures.
In or near the ship's brig, which should narrow our search.
Crap. Cool.
Yeah, so the lore of those things is like they're just like swarms of worm nests or something, and they can like take on different forms. So for instance, the scarab vehicles that you see throughout the rest of the game,
yeah,
those are actually just the Megalic Golo worms. It's
so,
very bizarre.
Oh, weird.
So like it's weird because they have like command consoles and stuff, but technically those ships drive themselves. You'll see a scarab a little bit later, Ari, but I'm just responding to this person who says they're the size of a city block, which is true. They're just like sentient swarms.
What they don't tell you is that it's a flat ceiling. That's a suicide.
I like that it takes a while to lift him because he's so heavy.
Oh, I thought they were doing it for dramatic purposes.
No, he's 1,300 pounds.
No Covenant defenses detected.
He's got a cut
because
back.
Of all the spaceship armor on him. And the fact that he's like 8 feet tall.
Yeah, he's got a cut back. Like I said, he's a fucking space marine. Like, Warhammer. Compound V. Oh, you're gonna make Compound V fizzy lifting drink. Oh, those are cool. I'll watch those videos. Those are cool, Greg. I'm sorry, Juan. You're right. I won't fat shame. I won't fat shame Master Chief.
I'm pretty.
I know.
I'm
saying you should do them.
Oh god, sword guy. I'm pretty confident on my 1,300 pound guess because I know the armor is supposed to be like half a ton, and he's just a big dude.
So he weighs the other half of a ton?
Yeah.
I mean, I would insist that blue is a flavor, but you would disagree with me.
I know what blue tastes like.
Yeah. Blue has a flavor. It's in the ice pops.
I was gonna say, it's that blue syrup from the icy machines.
Exactly. that's the flavor of blue.
Listen, that flavor is certainly not any other flavor.
Right. Jasmine tried to tell me it was a berry, and I'm like, no, it's just blue.
I've had a berry.
I've had berries. I've eaten berries before. This isn't a berry. This is the color blue. But it is a terrible idea. You should do it. Make it a cursed drink. I mean, Compound V is a curse for most people. So we're just like stuck in these rooms.
So right now we're like getting a beachhead or whatever on this Covenant ship and letting all our dudes die.
Well, yeah, that's cool.
And now we gotta fight some hunters. You remember them?
Oh yeah, fuck them. Fuck them. As we say on this stream, click that spit. Which is a long story that I don't feel like telling.
We say that? I don't say that.
No.
You're in my way.
We is me. I was speaking royally because I'm awesome. I refer. So you remember when they edited movies for content on TV and you would watch it and they cover up the curses or whatever?
I
was watching like 2 o'clock in the morning on Sci-Fi Channel in high school. I was watching The Faculty. Josh Hartnett was frustrated because his teachers were turning into aliens, and instead of saying fuck that shit, they changed it to flick that spit. And it never left my brain, unfortunately. So now, when I don't want to curse, flick that spit. But it's not good. You don't want to say that. It's gross.
I'm not going to.
Yeah, you should.
I want to say good old adult curse words. That's me. Adult human man.
Suck my kiss. Exactly, Salty. You know what movie I watched when I was younger that I didn't realize was rampantly misogynistic and, like, uncomfortable to watch?
Half of them?
Most of them, yeah. But last night I popped on John Carpenter's Vampires with the previously mentioned James Woods. And boy, that's bad. It's a bad movie. Yeah, Juan. I told the story. Either I'm on delay, or you can go back. I've told it twice on the stream now. It's just I watched a movie and it was edited for content, and they said that instead of fuck that shit. And I'm not alive, Pat, for the record.
I know. I just needed to get those guys out of there. Now you're alive.
No, I was just telling you in case you wanted another suicide.
I appreciate that. I did know that you were dead. I needed to get that red elite to die, and he was messing with me.
Yeah. The women are literally objects in that movie. I turned it off when, for no fucking reason, Laura Palmer from Twin Peaks was naked and chained and duct taped to a bed. Like, I was like, pass.
That's good.
Yeah, no. She was bit by a vampire, but she was like woozy and delirious and not doing anything. And why take off her clothes? Like, why was that a part of it? Ugh. Is this skeezy as James Woods is in real life?
Is there an invisible guy in here?
No, there's just this dude. Yeah, I would agree, Salty. If I ever watch that movie again, it will not be sober. Or willingly. I guess I'm saying, like, I'd have to be bound in, like, drug.
Oh, my dad.
Well, you shouldn't do that.
Yeah, I think
I'm not good. I'm not good at video games.
If you...
And now I'm gonna walk back. keep going
I was
back.
Like, you should back up. And you charge the room. Like, oh, that's the opposite of walking back. There we go. Now I'm back. You're good.
I didn't want to. I like the guns.
I understand that, but that room is a dangerous place, especially when those sword guys start coming in, because they will one hit you, and they are invisible.
You're invisible.
They have a name for the sword class.
So what's going on here?
What is going on here? Well, the doors are locked.
Except for this one, which we just came out of.
That doesn't seem right. Yeah, it should be another door
that
opens.
Hey, there's an enemy.
Oh, there's just like these guys over here.
Yeah, there's just a few guys. Just a few. Ow. I'm in pain.
The choice to give them like weird little cute voices. I don't know why they're the only ones that speak English.
Yeah, they speak English and like, oh, don't kill me, please. I'm the mayor of the Lollipop Guild.
Yeah, more so than the other Halos, this one has that old video game trope of just, like, throwing wave after wave after wave of enemy at you. Okay, now we can move forward.
Yeah, I would say that in memory. I have, like, I'm glad Pat played this before, because I'm just going in random directions. There is no navigation in
before
this.
Before we go that way, before we go that way. There is going to be another one of those cut scene things somewhere.
Right? Because you gotta add the dead bodies, Salty. That's my job. Like Oppenheimer, I have become death. I just got dark. I died.
The skull, I do not remember.
I have become death.
I'm assuming the skull is like up on top of a ship in the hangar or something.
So hopefully my emotes will get approved soon, but I definitely made, in tier one, you get a fail emote. So every time I die, you can put it in my face. Gross. Title of the top of my sex tape. Gross. Old Pat? New Pat? Young Pat? Old Pat? Oh wow, the difference in the ship is huge.
Oh yeah. The surrounding...
The floor is so fucking different. Wow.
Yeah. Yeah, they made a lot of really interesting choices. I mean, one of the things they did is they just tried to bring all of the enemies in line to, like, the visual style that they had decided to go with. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Like, they shorted up. It would be like going back to Dragon Age Origins and making that everyone look like the rest of Dragon Age. Like, the Qunari have horns and shit. They totally retconned that. They're like, oh yeah, Sten was like a special Qunari that didn't have horns. Okay, whatever. You decided to give them horns in Dragon Age 2. Don't lie. So cool that you can, like, because it makes a mechanical difference at certain points.
Oh yeah, well, because the walls are like in different places.
Yeah, so like it may be advantageous to go back to old Halo. I don't want it to be. I like the new Halo. They put a lot of work into it. Good job, 343.
Wow, they got me. You should
find
cover.
I'll back up. I'm backing up.
There we go.
Okay.
Yeah, the needlers, man. They're like, they're so delayed, but they'll kill you every time. Oh, there's the health pack I was looking for. They're up there. I really miss my DMR battle rifle. They are not in this game. I'll be back later. sort of get this just spray and pray assault rifle for this whole game.
The spray and pray assault rifle works, though. Like, it fits my ethos.
Well, yeah. That checks out. Is this an overshield? Hey, overshield.
Wait a moment. I'm going to access the Covenant battle and locate an override code to open a door. Working on it.
Stop it. Stop it! Why did they all come? What? What? What did you do, Pat?
Because we're unlocking a door.
Pat, what did you do?
Where have you gone? Are you dead?
Yeah, I'm dead.
Try and be alive. Yeah, we have to defend the door.
Ugly Pat.
It's just like when you take Dinglebot and you tell him to crack a Hive Triptark of runes.
Oh yeah, hit the hack button.
Yeah, it's the same thing. That's what this is.
Which, by the way, in Cyberpunk, I literally have a hack button that I click whenever my Netrunner hacks. In the game I play with Greg. Oh, have fun with that sword guy. That looks like that's working out well for you.
Are you dead?
Yes!
How are you still dead?
It says too many enemies nearby.
Yeah, well, that would be the big guys there. I thought you were alive again. I thought I spawned you in like that.
No.
Did I spawn you in? You died?
No! I was dead this sure. entire time.
Okay, well,
I said I was dead. Now I'm alive.
These big tank worms are... Give me problems.
Give me the needle. I want that.
Ow. Okay, there we go. They really just like throw those guys at you like crazy in this one.
I'm glad you stopped in for this one in memory, because you were the one who requested that I do Halo. You instigated this whole thing.
Oh yeah, DMR is so dope. The assault rifle is actually good in Halo 1, and they definitely find ways to increase the difficulty in later Halos, but... The assault rifle becomes absolutely garbage for like the next four games.
That's or whatever it is.
Yeah, it's like super useful here, and it will never be useful again.
But
basically.
Is it still like your default gun?
Sometimes, depending on the level.
All right.
Especially because, much like the pistol in this game, the wombo combo is the overcharged plasma pistol with, in later games, the DMR, in this game, the pistol, because you can drop an elite's shield with one hit from the overcharged pistol and then put a single bullet from the pistol or the DMR into their head and kill them, which is exceptionally helpful, especially on harder difficulties. Also, the grenade throw in this is... really goofy.
Stop it. And you're not consent.
Done. Yeah, they have a couple of these levels that are just these like massive messes of confusing corridors. I mean, I shouldn't even be complaining now, because wait until we get to the library, my dude.
Oh, good. There's a library.
Oh, you're like the library. The library. That's all. Did you throw a grenade at me?
No, I was trying to throw a grenade at the guys, and you just were where the grenade was.
So the answer is yes.
But yes, not at you to kill you. If I want to kill you, I will.
The SMGs rule in ODST, and they are pea shooters in the other Halos.
Oh god, Elite. He's lead Zors. Two lead Zors. Although everyone's talking about, I know, like, yeah, sure, the SMGs were, they were terrible. But now they're, but they were good out. In that one.
There are no letters. SMGs in this game.
All
You're
right.
not going to get to play with an SMG for a while.
Cool.
ODST also had probably the best ad campaign, maybe for anything, definitely for video games. It's up there just in general as well as one of the best ad campaigns has ever made.
Everybody talks about ODST like it's the best one, but it's the one where you don't play Master Chief at all.
Hey, watch your mouth.
I'm just saying. Like, you're selling me on this series. You're like, my best buddy Master Chief, but wait till ODST, and oh my god, Reach? Forget about Reach. You don't play him in either of those.
That's true. ODST is just really interesting because it's sort of a deconstruction in a lot of ways of a Halo game. And Reach is phenomenal because it was like it was their last game, and so
it was
Bungie like
saying
them
goodbye.
After, yeah, it was their peak of everything. Basically, they did everything that they've done in every other Halo game, but they did it the best there.
What? Oh, I got jumped. I checkpointed.
Yeah, you got...
Glitch in the Matrix.
Oh, maybe not.
Oh boy! Oh no!
Nope, oh, yeah, this is the control room. Okay, so when you see sleeping grunts next time, you can just punch them and they won't wake up.
Oh, that's cool.
You did alert everyone in this room, so we do need to deal with that now.
Well, I'm dead, so you need to deal with it.
Well, I see that you found the sword. Okay, so this time...
All right.
Stealth.
I thought this was like Doom. I thought you just blew everything up.
You have to use your big Master Chief brain.
He does not have a big brain. It's weird that they're just sleeping on the job.
It is a little weird.
Like, I mean, do the Covenant have nap time? Oh, you're down? F that.
Yep.
Flick that spit.
The Ungoy definitely have nap time. They have to do their They have to do their recreational drugs and huff their methane tanks. That is also 100% true. Okay, so I'm gonna try and get the sword guy. You deal with the grunts.
Yeah.
Because he keeps going to fight you for some reason. Boy, he just dodged that shot. Don't love that. I got him, but he got me.
Wow. What? Okay. Okay. Okay.
Okay. I'm not turned around, though. Is this way forward?
Yeah.
Oh, wait. You died. I thought you got it. You
no.
Just respawned me.
Yeah.
Okay.
How? What? Ugh, grenade. Ugh. Thank you, Artistic. Sit up straight. There you go.
Come here, don't run away. There's like a sword guy right around that corner.
Your sword guy right around
the corner. Yep, there he is.
I'm still dead, for the record.
Yeah, I know, you're still dead. I can't... It's given me a needler. I need you to stay alive.
Okay. Because
he's going to charge me, and
I'm
going
to stay. I will listen to you and stay alive.
Yeah, I just don't have a way to drop him because the needler is delayed damage.
It's Mandalorian rules, Werecat. I think one book described what he looked like.
Oh, I survived. Okay. Master Chief's appearance? No, they don't really.
What? Ever how?
How? How are you dead? Where? I left how? You in a hallway. I left you in a hallway. You had one job.
They threw. They must stay have thrown in... a grenade.
Maybe stay here.
I no. I'm playing the game. I'm playing the Halos. I want my circles. Damn it. I'm gonna get all the Halo. Circles.
Just wait until we take out the sword. Okay.
Get a little shot of those dreamy eyes of Master Chief.
Yeah, he's from one of the colonies, which I think are implied to be mostly Hungarian occupied. So he's probably Hungarian, but they do kind of a Gordon Freeman thing, but they don't let you see his face.
Just like Gordon don't speak.
Yeah, they do like an everyman, sort of.
Well, he sounds kind of like every action hero.
Alright, so up here, at this terminal, is your next thingamajig.
Oh, cool.
On the bridge. Yeah, this is the bridge of their spaceship.
Which one has the thing?
The red flashing one.
Well, it's not doing anything, bud.
You have to hold... I don't know what the button is for you. But...
There we go.
Armstrong, who is your maker?
Sizes. What do they show his eyes in 4? I played 4 once a million years ago, but I didn't love 4. I didn't love any of the new ones. I mean, actually, I didn't play 5. I don't have any opinions on 5.
Never made, but you are right here, where you should not be. Tell your charges to cease their efforts immediately, or a team must not be violated.
Well, I'm sure he looks like a mutant freak under there, because he, like, didn't go through puberty because of, again, all the weird... surgery, construct, augmentation, respond. Drug stuff that they did to our poor boy Master Chief here.
Familiar terms. I serve. None serve me, Oracle.
This is such gibberish.
Your charges must cease all aggression towards the reclaimers and leave this installation.
Yeah, you have no context for any of the story they're telling right now.
Construct, you're dangerously close to
yeah, that's true. Librarians did mutate him.
Oh, gross. That was gross.
This is yeah, don't worry about that.
We follow the path, and I am part of the stone journey.
Yeah, there's a reason he keeps the helmet on, I think.
We serve.
Not everybody gets to be Pedro Pascal under the mask.
And then I will be
yeah, no, some people keep it on for a good reason.
Free? Explain yourself.
I know their path, and when they have gone, only I shall.
That's true. Plus, they also imply that, like, all of the Covenant weaponry, like, gives off, like, ambient radiation
this
that is just, like, bad for humans to
construct.
Be around.
Your core shows no hint of understanding the gravity of this situation.
He's just a bulking super soldier body with a baby head.
That's what I'm picturing now.
Well, unless the blood kills us all, first.
Like, just a not to scale, a human... baby's baby head. Just like a little baby head underneath.
His scale in Halo 1 is a little strange. Like, he's got, like, a very big torso. They get his scale a little bit better in the other games.
I guess. I mean, he seems right to me for an 8-foot-tall baby-headed super soldier.
But yeah, the Covenant ships like this one, the reason that... lose all of the, like, space battles against them, aside from the fact that plasma weapons are crazy strong and their ships are faster at FTL, is that because they build their bridges in the middle of their spaceships, we have to, like, shoot through the ship to kill them, but all of the human ships, like, put their cockpit at the front like it's a car, and so the Covenants win, like, every space battle at the beginning because they just shoot at where we drive the ship from right away. And you would think that we would change that, but it takes them a long time in Halo before they actually make that change. Humans love having their bay windows.
8-foot-tall murder baby who sounds like like every action hero, like he's trying to do Snake Plissken from Escape from New York. I bet you that's a modulator. I bet you that's the helmet. I don't even think he has teeth. I think he has to eat applesauce. I think he's just gumming it.
I'm trying to remember if the suit provides nutrients. I don't think it does. I think he does need to eat.
Right, applesauce.
You definitely are wearing
a baby head.
You are wearing fusion reactors on your back.
Fusion reactor, 8 foot tall baby head, man.
Captain must be in one of them. We need to keep looking for him.
Oh, we gotta go. More different prison cell. The princess is in another castle.
How do we open this? It's probably this.
I don't know, dude.
Do it.
I know I can kill you if I feel like it.
Well, let's see if we can figure out how to open the doors. Oh, there we go. The doors are open. There's nobody in these. I thought we needed these open for some reason.
Yeah, exactly, Juan. Like RoboCop, except instead of being Peter Weller, he's just a baby face. That's Master Chief. That's canon. We've established.
I don't know that we've established that. Okay.
No, we have.
All right, we came from this way. It can't be this way.
This is old Halo. Look at that. Look at this junk.
Hey.
I'm having a good time. I'm just giving Pat shit.
I'll fight you.
I know you
will. I'll break quarantine and come and fight. I'm not going to do that. That's crazy.
You would never do that. What are you talking about? The last time we saw each other was a protest.
Hey.
I'm starting right from the beginning, mainly. This is my very first.
I made a mistake!
I died!
Well, I shouted I had made a mistake. I don't know what other warning I could give you.
I mean, it happened. Right, I died right as you yelled it. Okay. We're playing the original. It's the remaster, but so like you can switch between looking old and shitty or looking cool. Yeah. So, Pat, who sometimes is in my Destiny stream, is my guide through Halo because I've never played it before, and he's read all the comic books and novels. And
I have not read all of the comic books and novels.
He has. I'm pretty sure he has a tramp stamp of Master Chief. I think that's canon too.
His name is John 117.
Okay, you have John 117 as a tramp stamp. That's canon now.
My gun is out of batteries.
my gun was kind of out of batteries too. I am not a good friend. Die?
Does anyone here have a gun that I can use? There we go. Much better.
All right, where's our key? We gotta get Captain Keys.
There we go.
Uh-oh.
Coming here was reckless. You two know better than this. Thanks. Marines, lock and load your weapons. Let's be ready to move.
Okay, yes, sir.
While the Covenant had us locked up in here, I overheard the guards talking about this ring world. They call it Halo.
No.
One moment, sir. Accessing the Covenant Battle.
That's the title. That's the title of the game.
Holy shit. But where's the evolved combat? Religious significance.
If I'm analyzing this correctly, they believe that Halo is some kind of weapon, one with vast, unimaginable power.
Got it. It's the One Ring in Space Death Star.
Covenant kept saying that whoever controls Halo controls the fate of the universe.
Oh, and then they do a Dune reference? Fuck.
Dude, the Halo got a spin.
Whoever controls the Halo controls the universe. Chase Spice. Fuck.
That's bad news. If Halo is a weapon and the Covenant gain control of it, they'll use it against us and wipe out the entire human race. Chief. Cortana, I have a new mission for you. We need to beat the Covenant to Halo's control room.
Are you sure?
Marines,
I think what from what Pat told me, humanity's pretty shitty. Maybe we just let us die. Giant space worms.
There's the hunters. They are space worms. We should
head back to the shuttle. But they're not Shai Hulud, the maker. Bless his passing.
Oh, right, invisible. God, they get me every time. I always just wander forward.
Why are you doing that, Pat?
You should really stop doing that.
I mean,
okay, yeah, that's why you need to stop doing that.
That's awesome. It's one of these levels.
Yeah, dude, it's our captain. It's Captain Keys.
Yeah. But like, 50% of video games just like don't give them health. They're like unkillable plot devices.
No, you murdered the captain of our spaceship.
Good. I'm glad.
Oh, that's what I was going to say. Yeah, the reason he went down with the ship in the beginning and Cortana went with us is because...
he's a captain. Got to go down with the ship.
That's part of it. But right now, the Covenant do not know where Earth is. And it's the biggest secret in the war. And so anytime that like a ship is going to lose a space battle, which I mentioned is most of the time...
So they got to get rid of the AI, which is why I got Cortana.
They have to pull or destroy the AI and then like wipe all the computers, basically.
Got it. Well, I mean, no network drives, otherwise the Cylons can take over, right?
That's exactly it.
I'm just gonna make this every other thing that I already learned.
Come out wherever you are.
Come out wherever you are.
There is a giant space worm. Yeah, we'll get there. That's true. I was like, there's a giant space worm? Yeah, if you look at it that way.
I'm sorry, in memory. I can't help but see these things.
Yeah, no, this entire first game is intentionally just sci-fi tropes, very clearly. They were just writing their own little love letter to sci-fi stuff.
Girlfriend very casually went for a spare headset. That was what that nod was.
Ooh, that's a sword. Okay. Hey, I'm fine. I'm okay. Oh, there's another one.
Oh, he died.
No.
Yeah, notice how the key to progressing is named Keys.
Yeah, that was on purpose. That was 2001. They hadn't invented writing yet, Ari.
Right. That's not... This came out after KOTOR, right?
Yes. Did it, actually?
No, it might have been contemporary.
I'm in trouble. I need some help. Well, my gun is out of batteries.
Who are you talking to me? Oh, my God.
I need your help. My gun is out of batteries.
I have not seen the first beta of Halo.
It was originally for the Mac, and it was an RTS a la Age of Empires.
Got it. That's what In Memory was saying. He's saying it's like Halo Wars.
That's true. Okay.
We made it.
To Echo 419.
Thank God.
Extraction on the double. Negative, Cortana. I've been engaged by Covenant Air Patrols, and I'm having a tough time shaking them. You'll be better off finding your own ride. Sorry. Acknowledged, Foehammer. Cortana out.
Air support is cut off, Captain. We need to hold here until she can move in.
Oh, man! We're trapped in here! We're screwed! Man.
Game over, man! Game over!
Game over, man!
Remember, you're a leatherneck. Cortana, if you and the Chief
are one of those Covenant dropships, I can fly us out of here. You want Rico's Roughnecks?
Yes, Captain.
Starship Troopers. Right there. I can do this all night.
You will.
It was before KOTOR? Fair enough. Oh, yells in pain, then a death rattle. I like how they clarify that.
Oh my god, we're all the way back here.
Yeah, why not?
I hate Captain Key so much. I hate escort missions.
But he's the key.
He really isn't.
You sure? Because everything's kind of been about finding him. And he's had more lines than Master Chief.
Negative, Cortana, I've been engaged. Master Chief's not a big talker.
Yeah. Is he big? Is he big anything?
Just stay
he's
over
just
here.
a dude with a baby head. Cortana out.
Air support is cut off. Captain. I'd like to just shove him out of the way. She can move in.
No, game over. Oh, Dib came by? That's good.
I can stand on his head, though, so that is important information. I will defend him from here. No, they're just going to throw a grenade at me as soon as that door opens.
Wow. They came from behind!
Oh, is this what? This must be how they're killing him, as they're coming up behind us.
Hey, Pat. In memory says, you look exactly like he thought you would by hearing your voice in Destiny. I don't know if that's a compliment or an insult, but I'm going to say it's an insult.
Yeah, I know you will.
glitch in the Matrix. Whoa. I got pulled forward. That's cute. Speaking of my cat, he's all of my emotes. I submitted my emotes for approval, and there's a lot of my cat. It's neither. I know in memory, but Pat's an old roommate of mine. Like, we've known each other a while, so this is just how we talk to each other.
Are we old friends now? I hate that.
I hate that too, but we're both old, so.
Okay. I'll take it.
I hope they get approved. Yeah. I have a Discord server, and I gave everyone on the Discord server a peek at the emotes as they stand. So, thank you. Photoshop.
So weird to see.
I have like over 1,000 pictures of my cat because my girlfriend and I are a little obsessed.
Boy, when quarantine ends and Dib has to be reintroduced to people again.
Oh, I know. I don't even know how that's gonna go. He's so friendly now, though. He like
now the pillow theme is here.
He sits on top of both of us now, like at the same time. Stuff you wouldn't imagine.
What they call the silent cartographer is somewhere under this island. The cartographer is a map room.
This is the. This was the Wow U Tech demo of Halo. This level.
This was the train scene, like in Uncharted.
Contains the map
room. Yep. We're approaching the LZ. It's gonna be hot.
Oh wow, that is pretty cool.
We're doing a beach landing.
Oh yeah, that was pretty cool.
Well, this whole level is really good. That stick to me.
Hey, you're being asked if you're using Astros for your headset.
I don't know. Probably not. It's probably just like the cheapest. I actually have a new headset coming because the mic on this one has been acting a little funny.
I technically have an Astro. This Steel Series, its sound drivers are made by Astro. So it is an Astro headset with Steel Series branding on it. Yeah, it sure does. I mean,
I think we did it. Did you get an achievement there?
Not yet.
There's an achievement for taking the beach landing without losing any Marines.
Did we lose no one?
I didn't kill
anybody. No, we lost I didn't kill anybody either.
You're a liar.
No, wait. Yeah, these are all aliens. I don't know. I looked for humans. I didn't see them.
That's fine.
Oh, there we go. Warthog, you're driving. I'm guns.
So the fancy, the fancy tech demo was looking.
No,
out, looking
no,
out.
Get out.
You can just ask him to get out. Move out. Let's go find the fancy tech demo was storming the beach, but now that we've stormed the beach, the AI can only really do that. So they're just gonna hang out here instead of coming with us.
In memory, it has onboard EQ stuff. There's like a box that my headphone is routed into, and I can fully EQ stuff on that and have like profiles and shit. It's old, but it's still very cool. The only piece of tech I have that's new right now is my lefty mouse, which makes me so happy. It doesn't make me a better shot, but it does make me happy. Alright, Pat, just a heads up, and also for viewers, we're heading into about the last half hour I have scheduled for this stream.
Alright, let's blast through this then.
Let's blast it. Maximum overdrive.
We're gonna get
shoes
this back.
That make you a better shot. I'm barefoot right now.
Please shoot them.
Not wearing any shoes. I don't even have socks on. Best part about Twitch streaming is, like, as long as I don't stand up, I don't even need to be wearing pants. I'm wearing pants, I promise you, I'm wearing jeans. But I make no promises for Pat.
I'm gonna pull them out, well.
Don't pull anything out.
No, the elites. I was gonna drag them out so you could shoot them with your turret, but you got off your turret. So now we're gonna fight these guys. Oh god, there's so many of them! This was a horrible idea.
I love it. Pants are for squares. You're right, mainly. I am firmly anti-pants, but it's a psychological trick, because if I wear not pants, I can't work. Like, my brain goes, oh, it's time to just play video games. Down with pants. Agreed. Which is weird, because on Greg's stream, we talk about pants a lot. There's a lot of pants talking going on. We're very worried about what the pants are. See, I don't know if I can pull that off, man. I'm really skinny, and I'm not Scottish.
The Covenant are putting up a real fight. Cartographer must be here.
Why would I do that in memory? The map room should be at the bottom. I'm pale enough. It's true.
Let's keep going inside.
I mean, I won't lie that you definitely get better circulation. That's all right.
Locked.
I underestimated the Covenant's understanding of Halo subsystems.
I am half Russian. That does count.
The doors, and we don't have enough firepower to get through them.
Keeps, yeah, yeah, that's circulation. New York City summers are hot, too.
Yeah.
Negative, Captain. The Covenant have impeded our progress.
I mean, not this one, because we were inside. But...
Thanks for the help, Marine. I like how you sat here in the car the whole time. Keep the AC running?
You had to make sure that the headlight lamp fluid was still full. I'm just gonna keep doing that one red versus blue joke. We have to get to the
center. Listen, you're here for the references from 10 years ago, I know. It's probably more than that now. That is also probably closer to 15
years. It's
ago.
18 years old. No, 19. Halo is 19 years old.
Well, yeah, but Red vs. Blue came out after.
Oh, yeah. I was in middle school, though. I was not in high school when it came out, so... It was a long time ago. Because I remember watching it in middle school.
Yeah, they predate YouTube.
Yeah, I remember you had to go to their website to watch it. Look, I'll be the first one to say it. Male fashion traditions are way too rigid. Like, there's too much. Why can't we wear skirts? We got bits that need to breathe. God damn it. That being said, I don't have a skirt, but like, if somebody puts one on, you know, whatever. Well, we can't, they're called kilts. It's true. But again, very specific subset can wear kilts. Not everyone can pull it off. I got skinny pale legs. I'll look weird in a kilt. Yes. No, I think cable modems were like just coming out. I remember I got my dad is a tech nerd, so we got cable modems pretty early. Like as soon as we could. I'm pretty sure like it was new but still a thing. Alright, I got one. And I didn't die, Pat.
Cool. That is both of those. Now, there's an overshield here you should
pick up. You know, you should be careful, Maine. You got real bears there. We don't have bears. Well, the bears we have here are part of a particular subsection of a, like, particular lifestyle, but... That's the type of bears we have in New York. Oh, I grew up in, like, a Jersey suburb. So, like, everything... Like, I lived in a giant strip mall. And in Edward Scissorhands' cookie-cutter house. I go back to visit my parents, and it's so quiet, I can hear my internal organs operating. And it disturbs me. And then when people walk past me, they smile, and I don't get it. I'm like, what do you want? I don't have it. I don't got the money. The things you learn. Bears in kilts happen all the time during Scouts Pride Week.
Guess there were some grenades on the ground.
I guess there were.
Yeah, so on Legendary, there are so many Easter eggs in these games, too. There's just a bonkers number of them. Most of
Now, was it in the original, or is this just the collector's edition?
No. In the original. Most of them you can only see on Legendary, and I think on Legendary, like up around this corner or something, there's like a grunt that says funny things.
That's cool. I like that they put more content in the higher difficulties. It gives you a reason to replay.
Yeah, most of the Easter eggs are only on Legendary. Now, this is going to be a problem because
I'm playing.
No, I have zero ammo, and we've got two more hunters.
Oh, well, that's awful.
That was the last of that panel, so now I'm going to fight them with a pistol.
All right, yeah, I got 8 rounds in reserve beyond this clip. 8 more.
Oh, nope. All right, okay. Great, no problem.
I'm out. There we go. Well, I have 2 bullets in my assault rifle. I'll kill Pat just to kill him, but it makes sense.
Oh, that's true. So yeah, I know.
Panel to shut down the security system.
I know one of the skulls is here. Again, I think the skulls are only accessible on Legendary, though.
Good.
That might be true.
That should open the door that
leads
into the
main
shaft.
Oh, what's that guy?
He's another one of the God, what is their name? Reclaimer class? Prophet class? Whatever, sword elites that we've been fighting. They're typically invisible.
Mm.
But yeah, on Legendary, if you grenade jump like up on top of this thing or something, maybe it's not right here, maybe it's later in the level, there's a skull that you can grab.
Wow, look at the difference.
Yeah.
That's cool. This is nothing. Cool? Nothing.
Listen.
Cool. Where the heck did you go?
I left.
God damn it.
Oh, I still have no ammo.
Oh.
I'm coming back. I don't have any ammo.
Oh, is this a video? I watched that video, didn't I? Well, there you are down there. Pistol. The pistol is
That's
pretty
fine.
Fucking rad. I'm glad. I waited.
No, the pistol is incredibly powerful. Like, in any of the other games, three elites versus me with a handgun is going to end one way every time. In this game, no problem.
I'm just, like, vaguely following
Chief,
this
Bravo
distant
22
arrow.
Is bringing us some heavy weapons. After I saw we were up against hunters, I thought you could use them.
Oh, now we can use the heavy weapons.
Keep an eye out
but
for
not
any
before.
Cargo we can salvage.
Nope.
Where the F did you go?
I'm trying to jump. I think he... I don't know if I'm supposed to do this, but typically I just jump down here.
Mountain goading your way through shit is the way to play video games. Oh god. That didn't work. You did it better.
You'll probably respawn.
I'm here. I'm right here with you. We're together now. Unfortunately for you.
Oh, is there only one rocket launcher?
You get it. Take the rocket launcher, Pat. Enjoy. That was fun.
I'll hop back in. We gotta go for a ride.
Yay!
We gotta fight these guys.
Well, this actually looks
yeah,
nice.
Yeah, one of the first really popular YouTube videos was like somebody like trying to grenade jump their warthog over this whole island. Like,
huh.
I don't know. That was one of those early videos that had like 100 million views for no reason.
I actually, this part aged pretty well, old graphics wise. That was respectable. I was not paying attention. I was marveling at the
You
graphics.
Have never once been paying attention. You are constantly not using the gun that you have been assigned.
Why? Why should I?
We
what
always
if I
want
to be a pacifist? Could I play
like,
this game
have,
as a pacifist?
I'll have a Happy Meal. I'll take a Big Mac with a side of fries. I'm like, please shoot at them.
What were you expecting playing this game with me, man? That I was going to be helpful?
I just thought you might use the gun that you were holding. I didn't need you to be good with it. Are you dead?
Yeah.
That's
I'm
because
alive.
You're not using the gun. You should really use the heavy weaponry against these guys.
Well, go, right. Come on! Ow! Come on! I died.
Yeah,
because the warthog right. did warthog stuff.
Yeah. Okay. So
I'm
this
calling,
time, stay
it's
on
the puma.
Gun.
It's the puma for the rest of this game.
It's not a puma.
It is a puma. It looks more like a puma.
Please don't. Please don't do this.
Oh, I will. Although I'm blue team, I have a caboose shirt. There. See? I'm pressing the left mouse button. Are you happy?
There's no reason not to. You literally don't run out of ammo. I shouldn't have to keep asking you. Okay, there's one. Look how easy it is.
It wasn't that easy. I just got flipped the fuck over.
Well, listen.
Nope, not driving. Not driving. Getting in the back and then doing this. In the back.
Okay, now we can move forward.
Cool.
Whew.
That was easy.
Oh, we're making good time. We're going to do this level no problem. I've cursed us.
I know you have.
Now there's gonna be a guy with a sword at some point.
It's got tusks.
Remember to use your gun.
Wait, what?
Yeah, I know.
I can't. Now, cutscenes
that being
happen.
Said, I. That being said, I did forget that I had a rocket launcher that I could have used on those guys at any point, but instead I didn't. I've heard of like three of those strains, and I am not a stoner, so.
Gelato's the only one I've had out of that list.
That you've had or that you've heard of?
I've had gelato. I've never,
no, I'm saying,
but never even heard of a bunch of the
heard
others.
So if you punch elites in the back, they'll instant die.
Right. Especially when they're sleeping on the job for no fucking
reason.
Well,
those are grunts. That's the same thing. Elites never sleep, but they you can still punch them in the back and still kill them.
Girl Scout cookies is very prolific. I died.
Oh, good. That's ideal. I wish I had my hunter dodge.
Sorry, Pat. Pat's a lightweight, weed-wise. He's, one of these days I'll relate the story of you and the edible chocolate bar in Seattle.
Listen, that thing hit you too.
Yeah, but not as bad. Listen. And I waited until I was back in the hotel room, not when I was demoing games.
I didn't know what was gonna happen.
You didn't check the dosage on the
I did
chocolate?
Check the dosage.
No,
it
said two servings.
I know, and I had one. I thought nothing was happening. So I had more, which is the same as how every story goes. Because I was a little high, but I wanted to be a little more high, and then I was a lot more high.
You were incapable of human speech.
I couldn't call an Uber.
And you had done that to get to the place we were at.
It's one button.
Mr. Friend's mind crumble. That's some of the shit named after my character. Mainly has marketed my cyberpunk hacker. He's turned him into a bunch of weed strains, and I think that's cool.
You know, I just realized, I'm not sure where the terminal is in this level. Oh, well.
Oh, cool. Good guiding. Great guide.
Well, the terminals are only in the remastered version, so that's probably why I don't remember, because I've only played through once to grab the terminals, whereas I've played through the other stuff a few times.
You've got two enemy dropships coming in fast.
Fair enough.
Damn it. Okay, people, we got company coming. Let's set the table. Engage enemy forces on site.
Engage them.
It'll be easier to hold them off from inside the structure. Can you get inside?
Negative. They're closing in too fast. Negative. Gotta find the cartographer. We'll keep him busy as long as we can.
Give him hell, Marine.
Yeah,
we're looking.
Hell.
We'll be in a tight spot if we don't get out of here before additional reinforcements arrive. Let's find that map.
Let's find the map. And then the map will lead us to the gate, and the gate will have a key, and we'll need to open the key.
Well,
and then there'll be more circles.
We're looking for a map to go to the control.
I really may rename this stream Circles with Pat.
We're not really even in the circles part yet. We're just on one. I mean, I don't think it is a spoiler. You do know that there is a Halo 2.
Yeah. That's why I'm Circles.
Spoiler alert.
I already saw more than one circle in this game. There's plenty of circles. They're everywhere.
There. That holo panel should activate the map. Analyzing. Halo's control center is located there.
Oh my god.
I know he's literally right. I still get there.
It's my superpower. So
it's just very formulaic early 2000s.
No, I was about to say, so I'm all caught up on Infinity Train, and I called the twist, like, immediately.
It's bad, dude.
In season 3. I'm just saying.
I didn't think there was a huge twist in that season. I didn't expect there to be.
There was.
I mean, which twist are you talking about?
Hazel.
Oh. Yeah, I mean, everybody knew that they were that. Yeah, I mean, yes. It was presumed that Hazel was a product. Though it is interesting that they didn't entirely in the show unpack exactly who she is.
Well, they played her like a real person, like she was on a quest.
Well, yeah, but everybody knew that she. I mean, like, let me retract that. Between like Liz, Adi, and myself, like there were
three people knew.
The three people that I could get to watch it with me.
Who are all very intelligent and right.
Yeah.
Yeah, those three people.
Yeah, I guess it's kind of a twist. Fair enough. How about that freaking last scene, though, dude?
Holy fuckballs.
Yeah, they go full Raiders of the Lost Ark on you.
I was not prepared.
No, the show has
Infinity
several moments
Train's hardcore.
Where you're like, I'm watching a kid's show, and you were like, this is not a kid's show anymore. What just
happened? There have been definite moments where I'm like, nope, that shouldn't be there for kids. It's why it's on the brink of being canceled, honestly.
So good. It is like one of the best written shows.
They
want
to do 8 seasons so that they can get it to the infinity symbol.
Oh my god, is that true?
Yes. I'm confirming what the showrunner has said. I write for an entertainment website.
I haven't seen that particular interview yet, but that's very good.
Yeah, he wants hopefully to do 8. He also wants to go to time periods. So he wants the train before trains existed. So, like, prehistoric people riding the train. He wants to do shit like that. And I'm on board. Infinity Train is so fucking cool.
It's so good. The end. Just...
Yeah, if you haven't watched Infinity Train, it's on HBO. Go watch it. It's really fucking cool.
It's some of the best media that's being put out right now.
Yeah, they do like the Adult Swim 11-minute episode shit, and they pack in more pathos into 11 minutes than most dramas do in a season.
Yeah, it just narratively is one of the best constructed 3-season arc of anything I've ever seen.
Yes, I was just writing an article about season 2 today, because everything about season 2 is fucking amazing.
May have wasted my rocket there. I probably should have saved that for the sword guy, but
wasted that rocket, brah. Oh no, it's happening.
What's happening?
I'm saying bro all the time.
Oh, that's your own fault.
I will say this. So, like, my parents and I do a trade. So I get their HBO, they're on our Disney Plus. That's the trade. HBO's fucking sweet. HBO Max has really good stuff. Mm-hmm. Raised by Wolves is cool. It's Ridley Scott's greatest hits.
Oh, there he is. Back up.
Whoa. I'm running. I'm going. I can't run. There's no sprint.
There's no run.
I'm okay, walking deliberately in my spaceship armor. Rebels is great. What are you talking about, memory? Rebels is fantastic.
Rebels?
Yeah, we are talking about Star Wars Rebels.
God, it's good. It was like the first good new Star Wars we got.
Let me say this. Clone Wars has peaks and valleys, and Rebels never gets as high as the Clone Wars, but also, Rebels never had Jar Jar in it. So, Rebels. Rebels is good. That's not true. The best part of Clone Wars was that they... I mean, the best part of Rebels was that they brought Thrawn in. That was the best part of Rebels. Yeah, Pat, meet in memory, he also ascribes to Darth Jar Jar.
You mean the truth?
Yeah. Listen,
wake up, sheeple. All right, so we got our map.
Rebels is rad. Rebels is really cool. They did a lot of stuff with the Force. Kanan Jarrus, Ezra. There's good stuff in there. And they so much set up with the Mandalorians. I mean, because of Rebels, we're getting Ahsoka Tano and Bo-Katan in Mandalorian Season 2. So that's exciting. I like Rebels. That being said, the latest season of Clone Wars, the one that just came out, was like one of the fucking best things I've ever seen. Holy shit.
I'm gonna go watch that again.
Yeah, the last season of Clone Wars is fucking outrageous. Oh, man. All right, so this is the start of a new scene, right? We're about to... When we get through this scene, we'll probably wrap up.
Because now we're going to go find the control room that we found a map to.
This is as far as I can go. Roger that. We'll be able to find our way to the control center from here. Good luck. Bohammer out.
The Siege of Mandalore was one of the best things I've ever seen. I'm just going to say that. Alright, so I'm gonna hop out now. I think this is a good spot. End game. Cool. I wanna thank everybody for joining. Begrudgingly, I'll thank Pat over here.
Haha, you did it. You said thank you.
Thank you, Pat. You're a good guide. You know lots of stuff about Halo. So this is the thing. We're gonna keep doing this. I got a lot of Halo games to play, and I gotta learn more about my new buddy Master Chief. So we'll probably stick for Mondays now. If things change, I'll let people know. Other than that, I'll be on Wednesday for Destiny, and then Thursday for Cyberpunk. All right, peace out, people.
Yeah, we're halfway through.